Is this a vase or two men?
Well, it's both.
Some things can be seen in totally different ways.
Is this a supply curve or a marginal cost curve?
It's both.
An individual marginal cost curve tells us the extra cost a seller incurs to produce one more unit of goods.
Let's start with producing one unit of rice.
Well, look for the most fertile land.
Cool, got it.
Cost? 10 cents. To produce the second unit, we've got to look at less fertile land, so cost increases to 20 cents. As we produce more rice, we use up more land. Every additional land becomes less and less suitable for cultivating rice, and the cost increases for every additional unit. At the 100th unit of rice, the cost is $10. This is why the marginal cost curve slopes upwards.
What about the market marginal cost curve?
Simple. Combine the individual marginal cost curves to get the market marginal cost curve.
Is this a demand curve or a marginal benefit curve?
It's both. An individual marginal benefit curve tells us the extra benefit a buyer enjoys by consuming one more unit of goods. Imagine you are super hungry and consume the first unit of rice.
Brilliant!
What about the second unit of rice?
Great.
Third unit of rice.
To be honest, you're not that hungry now.
Okay. As you consume more rice, your marginal benefit drops. Combine the individual marginal benefit curves, you get the market marginal benefit curve.
Now, we've seen this before. Supply equals to marginal cost, demand equals to marginal benefit. This is the equilibrium. But why?
As a seller, if you are producing 3 units, should you increase production?
Yes.
The 4th unit costs you 40 cents. The price is 50 cents. You can still make a profit. Produce.
What about the 5th unit?
Cost is 50 cents. Price is 50 cents. You break even. Produce. 6th unit? Cost is 60 cents. And price is 50 cents. It's a loss. Stop production at the 5th unit.
As a consumer, part with your money as long as it makes you happy.
If you have consumed 3 units of rice, should you consume more?
Yes.
The 4th unit gives you 60 cents worth of happiness, but you only gotta pay 50 cents. So, consume. At the 5th unit, the extra happiness you get is 50 cents. Price remains at 50 cents.
Okay, let's consume.
At 6th unit, the extra happiness you get is 40 cents. Lower than the price of rice. Keep the money. No more rice. That's why that's the equilibrium.
Why do we always harp about oil running out? Yet those engineers seem to always discover new sources of oil.
Well, if oil costs $20, you are going to produce oil as long as your cost is below $20 by drilling the shallow oil fields only.
Is there a bone oil down there?
Yes, but it costs $30 to get it. Don't bother. Because you'll only be able to sell it for $20. It's a loss.
If price increases to $100,
drill for more oil all the way until your marginal cost equals to $100.
If price of oil increases to $200,
try anything to produce oil. Go to the moon, go to Mars, go anywhere to get oil. Because as long as your marginal cost stays below $200, you'll make a profit.
If you like this video, remember to like and subscribe. Next up, consumer surplus and producer surplus.